changes with respect to the characteristics of a chemical reaction. When can we say that a chemical reaction has taken place? So, when following conditions are fulfilled. Now, there are certain conditions that has to be fulfilled for a chemical reaction to happen. Okay, otherwise we see that chemical reaction will not take place. So, let's see what are those conditions. There are one or more reactants involved in the chemical reactions. We know that whichever equation that I explained to you had the involvement of one or more reactants. Okay, there is formation of one or more substance after the chemical reaction. The product that is formed, it might form one or more than one product. Energy is either absorbed or released in the form of heat and light. None of the reactants retain their individual identities, that is products in terms of colors, odor or physical state. Now, when the reactant combines to form a product, we see that their properties differ. For example, H2 and O2, these are gas molecules, but they combine to form water, and water is a liquid. The property of water and hydrogen and oxygen is entirely different, and even the states of matter, that is the physical states, are entirely different. This is with respect to when can we say that a chemical reaction has taken place, or the conditions that needs to be fulfilled for a chemical reaction. Next, let's go through the activity. For this, the main aim of the activity is to see change in color in a chemical reaction. I told you reactants combine to form a product. Okay, and how do we know that product is being formed? Might be one of the characteristic is by color change. In this particular beaker, we are taking sodium sulfide. Sodium sulfide is whitish in color. And to that, we are adding dilute sulfuric acid. Once you add dilute sulfuric acid, we see that sulfur dioxide is being evolved. Okay, now to that same test tube, you are adding orange colored potassium dichromate. So once you add to orange colored potassium dichromate, you can see a product being formed that is green colored. And that product is chromium sulfate. So this green color tells us that a product is being formed. Here we saw that initially it was white in color. Sodium sulfide was white. To that we added dilute sulfuric acid. Gas was evolved. And to that when we added potassium dichromate, we got a green color. That is nothing but chromium sulfate. So this is one activity to see color change in a chemical reaction. Now, next activity, one more activity to see evolution of a heat in a reaction. How do we know that heat is being released? Now, class, here plus symbol has been written. It means it is your exothermic reaction. It means the heat is being released outside. Here we are taking a test tube. To that test tube, we are adding sodium hydroxide. Okay, 1 ml of we are adding 1 ml of sodium hydroxide, and to the same test tube we are adding 1 ml of dilute HCl. What do we get? We get sodium chloride plus water, and heat is being released. This is an experiment to see evolution of a gas of heat in a reaction. Next, we are moving on to types of chemical reaction. There are several types of chemical reaction, but for today we will just discuss the very first, that is chemical combination reaction. The name itself is telling you that something is combining. Combination means combining. Something is put together. When two or more elements or compound react chemically to form only one new product. here what is happening? Here there are two reactants, A and B. It might be an element or it might be a compound. Now these two combine to form a single product. Then we call it as our chemical combination reaction. For example, carbon, when it combines with oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide. Here there are two reactants, but how many products are formed? Just one product. And one more example, H2 plus O2 gives rise to H2O. Here how many products are being formed? Just one product is being formed. Here we see that in chemical combination reaction, two or more reactants combine to give rise to a single product. And this reaction might be between the elements or compounds. Thank you.